An organisation that helps ex-forces personnel and their families realise their potential as entrepreneurs is celebrating its first birthday. Ex-forces has helped more than 170 businesses get off the ground in the past year and lent almost £500,000 in start-up funds. Ali Gibson has been in London to witness the celebrations.
The great and the good gathered in Wellington Barracks to mark a year of business success for ex-forces, set up to support those who choose to go it alone after military service. Since its formation, the scheme has supported 170 businesses and lent out £1.5 million to get new ideas off the ground. With 20,000 people leaving the forces last year and 4% on average wanting to go into business, the appetite is growing.
My football career, my military career was ended through injury and serious illness. But I always liked to train. And I found that through these serious illnesses, I was always searching for a way to train, even though it was very difficult. I'm an amputee now. So, but after a number of years on kidney dialysis, I've had two kidney transplants. I developed a body suit which allowed people to train and run in the swimming pool with no impact. And I work with Real Madrid Football Club, Manchester United, Liverpool, the England national team. They all use the body suit that you can see over here.
Ex-Forces has the support of Lord Young, the Prime Minister's enterprise advisor, and Startup Loans, their funding partner, part of a wider government scheme designed to get the economy back on track.
It's critical. It is the absolute enabler to support the seed funding for the startup businesses. You know, there's a lot of other things that need to happen to make them successful, but if that wasn't in place, there wouldn't even be a starting point. So it's vital, and we are so appreciative to be able to work with initiatives like the Startup Loans, the support of Lord Young, and actually what UK economy is trying to achieve.
Tied as it is with government initiatives, today three employers signed the corporate section of the Armed Forces Covenant, pledging their support to those who serve and have served.
Since the Covenant was introduced, its aim has been to support Armed Forces personnel, their families and veterans, and recognise our obligation to them. At times, that is about fair treatment, making sure that they get the same opportunities as everyone else. But it's also about special consideration for their background and their military service, and that's why schemes like this are so important.
Moving away from the chain of command in a military environment can be daunting, but that's why the mentoring programme has worked, recognising too the benefits of going alone.
It's strange not having a rank structure, but that is on the other hand one of the best things about it as well. You are your own boss. You get out of, well, we're reaping the rewards now, but we're getting out of the business what we put into the business.
It's the flexibility of controlling your own destiny.
Yeah, I definitely agree with that.
Ex-Forces may still be in its infancy, but the team here still have big plans for the future, helping make life in Civvy Street a freeing rather than terrifying experience. Ali Gibson, Forces News, London.